Hey guys, Jan here and welcome back to the present. And today we have a guest who maybe hindi niyo siya alam pero he's actually a famous guy, right? So I'm not gonna introduce him. I'm gonna let him introduce himself para malaman natin yung background niya, ano yung ginagawa niya, at the same time ano yung contribution niya sa buhay natin. Okay?
Kung meron.
So kung meron naman. So let me introduce you guys to Garett. So Garett.
Hi guys. So thank you Jan for having me here sa The Present, no. So idol na idol ko talaga 'to eh.
Grabe naman.
Okay. So yun nga, I'm Garett. I'm a registered chemical engineer. I practiced for 3 years in the industry and then later on I kind of medyo lumayo na ako dun sa field na yun. I'm now a full-time financial advisor. I've been practicing for almost 3 years na. And right now I'm also building a team. So unit manager ako. And I manage 40 advisors under my team currently. So ang mission namin is to actually help mag-spread ng financial literacy here in the Philippines. Kasi marami pa tayong gagawin dyan. Marami pa tayong kailangan gawin. So I also co-founded the Bright Millennial with my fiance Anne. So what we do there is we actually try to remind people or show tips and tricks on how to manage their finances.
Okay. So actually guys, The Bright Millennial is one of the pages that I personally follow. So if you haven't followed them yet, ano ba yung handle niyo sa Facebook?
facebook.com/thebrightmillennial.
Ayun, ganun lang, The Bright Millennial. So if you're a millennial, that's a very good page for you. So why did you start it to begin with? Like, I mean, creating a Facebook page and being consistent on posting content there, hindi naman siya ganun kadali.
Correct.
It seems easy, but it's not actually. So, ano yung nag-drive sa'yo na bakit mo siya ginawa and why are you consistent in putting out content and share the information to the people?
Alright. Dalawa yung main reasons ko. Number one, since I'm in the insurance industry, I really have to have leads. I have to talk to new people every now and then. But as an introvert kasi, I really haven't established my network. So parang very limited yung network ko. Now I have to find out a way on how to expand. So that's number one. Number two, I believe that financial literacy is really, really low here in the Philippines. Sabi ko nga kanina, marami pa tayong kailangan gawin dyan. And I think, di ba parang we always say na ang mga Filipinos ang top user ng social media, 'di ba? Napakarami natin sa Facebook eh. We spend so much time on Facebook. So why not we try to incorporate the topic of financial literacy, which is very important for us Filipinos, and then ilagay natin siya sa Facebook kung nasaan na 'yung mga tao. 'Di ba? So kahit papaano, kahit na medyo scroll tayo na scroll sa Facebook natin, kahit papaano meron tayong mga nakukuhang content that actually gives value to our lives, and very important that we know how to manage our money.
Okay. So two things is, number one is to get leads because you're in the insurance industry. Yeah. At the same time, it's financial literacy, you know, to educate people about finances. And sad to say, us Filipinos, we are like, yung financial intelligence natin, napakababa talaga. Siguro, from 1 to 10, meron tayo sa 3.
Okay.
Ganun, no? And that's what he's doing and that's what we're doing as well. Different lang nga yung style namin, di ba? Sa kanya is more on infographics. Sa amin naman is videos. And now, it's a collaboration with, you know, The Bright Millennial and The Present. Parang wow. What's with the done? No? Meron talaga siya doon. Okay. So, pagdating sa financial literacy, your market is mostly in Manila.
Yes.
Sa amin naman is in Mindanao or Davao area. Meron na kami mga Visayas. Most probably, iba yung kanilang concern from different areas. So, when it comes to financial literacy, ano ba yung common challenge or tinatanong ng mga tao sa'yo?
Okay. Siguro, ang main na tinatanong dyan is how do you actually save money? Diba? Kasi you cannot really invest if you don't save money. Diba? Parang anong ilalagay mo dun sa investment mo kung di ka naman nakakapag-ipon? And ang pinaka-question dyan madalas is, how do you save money kung talagang sakto lang yung income mo? Diba? Kasi lalo na ngayon, medyo nagmamahal naman talaga yung prices natin, nagmamahal yung prices ng goods and services. How do you manage all these things? So ang answer ko dyan, number one is budget allocation.
Okay.
Parang you really need to spend mindfully. Kasi most of the people, pag may pera yan, gastos lang ng gastos eh. Di ba? Bahala na, basta may pera ka, gastos ka lang. You don't actually budget the money. Like, kunwari, ilan ba dapat yung percentage sa needs mo? Ilan yung percentage na dapat sa wants mo? Ilan yung percentage na dapat mo i-save or invest? So, you have to allocate properly. And lagi nating sinasabi, di ba, parang you have to pay yourself first. Mm-hmm. Which is, madali lang siyang sabihin.
Mahirap siyang gawin
eh. Di ba? It's normal din. It's normal lang for people. Pero, if with the proper discipline, with the proper mindsetting, and then kung alam mo talaga ano ba yung goals mo, kung bakit mo ginagawa siya, then it becomes easier. Pero mas, syempre, mas masarap pa rin gumastos. Pero now, you are motivated to actually save money. And hindi lang kasi pagtitipid yung ano eh, kailangan natin gawin eh. Kailangan, maghanap din tayo ng mga racket, di ba? Maghanap din tayo ng extra income streams. We have to expand yung ating means. Mahirap din kasi na puro save lang tayo. Minsan talagang hindi kaya. Talagang sakto lang talaga eh. Diba? Hindi mo naman pwedeng pilitin. Hindi naman pwedeng from 3 meals a day, magayon mo na lang 2 meals a day ka. Diba? You have to find some other stuff that could actually earn you money. And napakarami naman nating free time. Ang dami yan nating time para mag-Facebook. Diba? So why not spend some of those time to be more productive?
Correct. Tama talaga. Actually, yung number one is similar savings rin yung mga common tinatanong sa amin, like how can you set aside uh-huh. a budget for yourself, and different yung situations. May ibang tao na students, uh-huh. meron yung allowance, wow. yun na lang yung income nila.
What is as early as students?
Oh, no? Meron na nagtatanong kung paano yung ano yung diskarte nila. And meron ding mga employees, mm-hmm. no? Like they are just earning minimum wage or they're just starting out in a company, uh-huh. so paano nila yung i-save? Meron din na single parent, dalawa yung anak, uh-huh. yun yung medyo mahirap kasi oo. you have children to parang correct. You need to ano ba. So pagdating naman, meron ka bang specific strategy or tactic kung paano mag-budget? Like for uh-huh. example, 10% goes to once, uh-huh. or meron ka bang ganun?
I do have parang a structure, pero you have to keep in mind that personal finance is very personal.
Kaya diba? Siya tinatawag personal
yes.
finance.
Yes, so parang we can recommend to people na dapat, ako personally ginagawa ko, 60% ay sa needs ko, that includes yung tithing. And then 20% for my wants, 20% for my investing. So that works for me, but it might not work for other people. Lalo na kasi ako, wala pa akong dependent, single pa lang ako. Diba? Parang I'm engaged pero wala pa akong family na sinusuportahan. And yung family ko, they can support din naman sila, yung parents ko. So it would be different for someone na breadwinner. Kasi baka magkaroon ng, syempre, mas malaki yung mga gagastos siya for the needs. Baka medyo mag-sacrifice ng konti yung wants and something like that. Pero ang general idea dito is we really have to save some amount of our money for the future, for our investing. And if you're going to ask me if ilang percentage ba yun, you could start small naman eh. Minsan when you try to do it big kagad, nabibigla ka, tapos parang feeling mo, ay, nade-deprive na
hindi
ako.
Hindi realistic.
Hindi rin siya sustainable, mm-hmm. di ba? Minsan, sige, on the first month, parang you have this hype na, sige, mag-iipon na ako ngayon. Pero after a few while, since parang na-feel mo nga na parang hindi ka na masaya, masyadong hindi mo na na-enjoy yung pera mo, you stop saving altogether. Mm-hmm. So parang, sige, build up mo lang 5% muna, 10%, tapos hanggang pataas ng pataas.
Na-mention mo rin kanina na mahirap talaga mag-invest if uh-huh. you don't even have savings. So, yeah. is it safe to say na the priority really is for us to save before investing?
Yes, you need to develop the discipline or the habit of saving money. Mm. Dapat yung cash flow mo. Lagi kang may surplus, mm. di ba?
Okay. Pagdating sa like finding ways to increase your income. Uh-huh. Because yun nga, na-mention nga natin na sometimes, some people, it's not practical for them to just save money, right? Yeah, because they have dependents and they need to spend on whatever things, right? Uh-huh. So, ano ba yung mga ma-recommend mo na mga sideline na okay uh-huh. lang?
No? Siguro before finding a sideline, kasi ang general idea is you have to learn more if you want to earn more. Mm-hmm. Diba? Kaya nga siguro tayo nandito sa NBU. Ayan. So you have to learn more, okay? Para example dito is, ako, I tried to learn about social media marketing. I tried to learn about digital marketing. Wala naman akong background on marketing at all eh. Engineering student ako eh. Engineering yung background ko. So I wanted to get into this industry. Ano lang, just for the extra income lang. So I tried to study through Udemy. yung mga online courses. So parang self-taught lang siya. Then after a few while, nung medyo maalam na ako, I tried to get some projects. Okay? I tried to nag-apply ako dito sa isang company, isang Australian company siya that handles ads for their businesses, ang mga clients nila sa Australia.
Okay.
So, I was just doing that on the side. Nasa bahay lang ako noon. Tapos, pagising ko, nandun na ako sa office ko. Pagkatapos na yung pagka-out ko, nasa bahay na ako kasi nga home base naman siya eh. So, marami tayong pwedeng gawin niya yun, lalo na online, na pwedeng makatulong sa atin mag-earn ng extra income. Hmm. Hindi ko lang sure, parang dati kasi madali lang pumasok sa, ano ba yun, Upwork.
Hmm.
Yung mga ganong sites. Ngayon kasi medyo tight na yung competition. Pero, if you actually want to do it, makahanap at makahanap ka naman ng paraan eh. Kung paano mo siya gagawin. Pero basically online, mga online stuff.
Online stuff.
Para madali siyang ipasok sa schedule.
Yeah. Actually, totoo talaga yung sinabi ni Garett when it comes to learnings, right? Like, I mean, some of us, ang gusto kasi natin mangyari most of the time is that when we want to grow our money, it's just lagay natin doon, bahala na.
Yeah.
That's like the common mindset. We don't want to understand the process of why is the money growing, or we don't want to go through the process of understanding kung ano yung ways or like paano siya gawin. Okay, so kaya nga marami ng mga tao na na-scam.
Na-scam. Parang they're saying na Filipinos don't invest kasi walang money. Pero makita mo, di ba? Ang dami. Na-scam nga lang.
Yeah. That's true. Okay, eto rin. When it comes to investing, marami kasing mga platforms, right? We have the stock market, we have mutual fund, we have VUL in the insurance industry. Meron ding mga business. Maraming ways, right? But before, kung ako ang isang average person, like wala masyado akong understanding about investing, I don't have any knowledge about it. Ano ba yung, like, non-negotiable principles na kailangan kong malaman before investing in anything?
Okay. Number one would be, you should know your goal. Okay. Why are you investing? Kasi when you set your goal, you probably have a time frame. Okay. And yung time frame na yun, kung short term, medium term, or long term ba yung goal mo, that is a factor when you're choosing what type of investment you're going for. Okay? That's number one. Number two, you need to understand the relationship of risk and return. Diba? Kaya maraming nasa scam eh. Kasi parang you are promised this kind of, parang you are guaranteed this kind of return without any risk. So that if it's too good to be true, it probably is.
Yeah.
So parang, sige dyan, doubling, ano, invest ka sa akin, tripling ko yung pera mo in 2 weeks, zero risk.
Okay. Diba?
Parang for some people, that would be enticing enough. And parang we get blinded. Diba? We get blinded by the return, by the promise of the return, and greed yung pumapaira sa atin dun eh. And when we nangunahan na tayo ng greed, that's when we make our bad decisions. And number three would be, never invest on something that you don't understand. Diba? Sabi mo nga kanina dyan, ang dami nating investment platforms eh, magsawa ka eh. Kung gusto mo talaga mag-invest, meron at merong fit sa personality mo, sa goals mo, sa time frame mo. Pero, you do not invest kung hindi mo pa siya fully na iintindihan. Okay, example, ako nung unang beses ako nag-invest sa stock market dyan, I lost a lot of money. I know it actually can make me money, pero I didn't really account na it could actually make me lose money din. So parang ang nangyari, yun nga, I lost money. Hindi ko naman siya alam. Alam ko lang, bibili ka lang company, tapos may possibility na tumaas. Parang hindi ko in-account na, okay, bababa. Pwede rin pala siya bumaba. So, tuition fee natin yun dyan.
Yun yung tuition fee. Totoo yun. Like, yun nga, swerte nga tayo eh, actually, especially now that we have the internet. Mas marami tayong platforms to earn income, and we also have a lot of platforms to learn before investing.
I agree, yes. Yeah?
So, we have free na mga information like the Bright Millennial.
Like you, like you know,
sa the present. Rin, and others. You know, marami naman chinkitan, if you want to follow them. Even mga United, mga tao sa US, marami naman talaga.
Yes.
Yun nga lang, hindi natin minamaximize yun.
Correct.
Right? We have the information on YouTube. We have the information on Facebook. Pero ang nangyari is, what we search on YouTube is yung mga Rafi Tulfo in action. Yung mga nakaka-entertain sa atin. Right? So, because of that, kulang yung information natin. And then we blame sometimes different people for our mistakes.
Correct.
In
Correct.
Investing in things. Kasalanan naman natin kung bakit tayo nag-invest na hindi natin naiintindihan.
Correct.
Alright, sige. Ito rin, maganda to. When it comes to like saving, meron tayong saving, right? Uh-huh. Meron tayong investing. Ang tanong ngayon is, especially sa mga taong philosophical yung kanilang approach, uh-huh, what's the end game? Ano yung main reason talaga? Ano yung end point kung bakit tayo nag-i-invest at saka bakit tayo nag-save? Is okay. it worth it? Is it worth our life to save and invest?
Okay, that's a good question. Kasi if you cannot establish that pa lang sa very beginning, magiging mahirap talaga yung pag-iipon saka yung pag-i-invest for you eh. And, pero I can say that yung end goal na sinasabi mo, it's going to be different for every person. Parang iba-iba tayo kasi nang gusto mangyari sa buhay natin eh. Some people are actually investing for their retirement. 'Di ba? Sobrang long term na noon. Like kunwari meron akong mga nami-meet na 20s pa lang, 30s pa lang. They're actually investing or preparing for their future. Pero meron din ako mga nami-meet na 20s, 30s din. They don't actually want to prepare pa for their retirement. Parang meron silang mas immediate na goals like setting up a business, buying a house, or setting up their families. So, iba-iba tayo na magiging end goal. Pero at the end of the day, you have to establish ano ba yung end goal mo na yun for yourself. Okay? Pero siguro ang general lang dyan, ang parang hindi natin pwedeng hindi account is medyo technical siya, pero yung term ng inflation, diba? If we're just saving money kasi, kunwari sa bank account, or even if nasa ilalim lang ng mga kama natin, hindi siya masyadong nag-earn for us eh. Diba yun yung term na tutulog yung pera natin. Pero we understand, we notice that yung prices ng goods and services goes up, diba, every now and then. Parang dati, magkano lang yung pamasahe sa jeep, diba? Yeah. Magkano inabot mo?
Pinaka mababa sa akin that was 6 pesos.
6 pesos, yan, mga ganyan. Ngayon, 9 na, mm-hmm, di ba? So, magkano na in-increase niya? So, inflation is would be around mga 4-5% on average. Yung savings natin, lang less than 1 lang yan kung nasa bank account. So, over time, even if you save money, parang eventually it would lose its value kasi mas mataas yung inflation rate eh, kaysa sa savings rate mo. Yeah. So you have to find a way kung paano mo lalabanan yung inflation rate na yun if you want to maintain the value of money, if you want to maximize it.
Which, based on, parang nabasa ko, like, on average, the inflation rate here in the Philippines on a yearly basis is around 3.5%.
3.5 to 4.
3.5 to 4. And then if you're just going to save money, yung nasabi nga na, like, banko lang, and then 1%, less than 1% per annum na.
Yeah.
Yung simple mathematics, kulang talaga.
Correct.
Right? Tapos if you're just going to save money and like lagay mo lang sa parador mo or saan lagay, then it's not going to save you, which is the reason why you're saving. So that it can save you.
Ganda yan.
Diba? Sa emergency, and then investment, right? Ganon. And another thing talaga for me, kung to answer my own question then, is more about yung end game talaga niya is that when we retire, when there will come a time that hindi na masyado tayo capable,
correct,
to work, right? Because of physical, medyo na tumanda na tayo. Uh-huh. Medyo, you know, darating yung time na ganun talaga mangyari. Hmm. Yun nga lang, when that time comes, expenses will still be there.
Yes.
Right? So, meron ka pa rin, you still need to eat, you still need to pay your bills, electricity, yeah, water. And kung wala nang pumapasok na income, ano, saan mo kukunin yung pera, yeah, diba? So those are the things na kailangan natin na i-consider, because especially if you have a family, you want to help them out. Financials, yeah, is one of the things that you can really help them out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, sige. Ito, sa insurance naman,
yeah,
insurance kasi is more, for me, is like, ano siya eh, parang, it's a need for people to have, but hopefully hindi ko muna siya gagamitin.
Yes, yes.
Diba? Kasi when you say you're gonna use your insurance, something bad already happened.
Correct.
It may be someone died in your family, or for example, sa car insurance, nagkaroon ka ng aksidente. That's the reason why you're gonna use the insurance.
Yes.
Yun nga lang, sana hindi natin siya gagamitin.
Correct.
Right? But we have to have it. Okay. Uh-huh. Since you're in the insurance field, ano ba yung kailangan na i-consider natin before getting an insurance?
Okay, so it's very important that alamin niya natin yan, yung mga dapat mo i-consider. Kasi insurance is a long-term commitment eh. Hindi naman pwedeng nakukuha ka lang ngayon tapos eventually para papabayaan mo na siya. Parang nagsayang ka lang ng pera. Para ka nag-contribute sa paluwagan and then hindi ka sumweldo. Para siyang ganun.
Okay, ganda yun.
Okay, so ano ba yung mga i-consider mo? Number one should be the type of insurance. There's a lot of debate online kung ano ba yung best
insurance
type of insurance for a person. Okay, ako as an insurance agent, I don't actually believe na merong best, na merong one type na best insurance. Ako, I believe in parang needs-based na proposal, needs-based recommendation. Kasi per person, iba-iba yung kailangan nila eh. Diba? So, meron tayong type of insurance na traditional. Traditional insurance would be those insurance policies that don't have a investment component. Mm-hmm. Then, yung kabila naman, yung variable life, variable universal life insurance, yung insurance na may kasamang investment. Now, maraming debates online kasi may advocates ng traditional or ng term or ng BTID, meron ding advocates ng VUL. So, lagi silang nag-aaway. Ano ba yung talagang mas maganda? It would depend kasi dun sa person. Like, kunwari yung person na to, meron ba siyang knowledge, meron ba siyang time to actually execute investing on the side, on a different platform? So, kung ganun siya, kung kaya naman niyang gawin yun, might as well go for a traditional policy and then invest ka na lang sa labas. Diba? You do BTID, yun yung lagi nila sinasabi, buy a term, invest a difference. Pero for other people, ayaw na nilang gawin yun. Gusto nila something na all-in-one na. Gusto nila convenient. And hindi mo naman sila masisisi kung ganun yung gusto nilang gawin eh. Kung ganun yung mag-work for them, edi ayaw mo sila, diba? Yun yung VUL. So that's insurance with investment. So parang all-in-one plan na siya. You're just investing regularly. You are insured. And then eventually, your money grows for you. Meron ka ng fund in the future. So, if something were to happen to you right now, at least meron mapunta sa family mo. Siyempre, ayaw natin mangyari yun. Pero kung wala namang mangyari sa'yo, at least yung money mo nga na nandun sa investment side, you could use that for future use. Yun. So that's one. That's consideration number one, yung type of insurance. You need to know what would work for you. Okay. Consideration number two, it would be the coverage. Okay. Ideal coverage that you have to have. Kasi, ewan ko kung ako lang to, pero mga Filipinos na nakausap ko about insurance, ang unang question nila would be, anong pinakamababa niyan? Ano yung minimum? Mm-hmm. Okay, parang yun kagad yung unang question.
Minimum na binabayaran.
Oh, minimum na binabayaran, okay. Minimum na premium. For me, hindi siya dapat yung unang question mo eh, kasi it defeats the purpose of insurance. So kung minimum lang yan, might not be able to actually support your family when you're gone. Okay, kasi insurance is not for you, insurance is for your family. So you have to consider them. Diba? Magkano ba yung gusto mong iiwan sa kanila? Tingin mo ba ito enough na to for them? Okay, you have to consider magkano dapat yung insurance na kukunin mo. Hindi pwedeng minimum lang. Okay? Kung yun lang talaga yung afford by now, okay lang yun. And then you just build it up. Pero if you can do more than minimum para mas pasok dun sa kailangan nila, then do that. Okay? Ang standard dyan would be 10 times of your annual income. Okay? Parang standard lang. Parang rule of thumb lang yun. Pero there's other ways to actually compute kung magkano ba yung kailangan mo. Okay? Siguro, one concrete example would be, example, nung 20 ka, bumili ka na insurance worth, ang coverage mo is 500,000. Then, pagdating mo ng 30s ka, meron ka na anak. Let's say, may dalawa kang anak. Diba? Do you think yung 500,000 coverage na kinuha mo nung 20s ka would be enough if something were to happen to you, given na meron ka pang dalawang maliit na anak?
Yeah.
Diba? So, parang, baka 1 year lang, wala na yun. Yeah. Diba?
Ubus.
Ubus yun. Oo. And then, yung third consideration, syempre, yung budget pa rin. Diba? Hindi naman din practical that most of your money goes to insurance. Diba? Parang, baka magamit mo ng maaga insurance mo kasi hindi ka na kumakain eh. Diba?
So, naman.
Kunwari, malaki yung ideal coverage na na-compute natin. Then, hindi pa siya kaya sa budget mo. Okay, yun nga, sabi ko nga, okay lang yun. It's a step-by-step process. You just build it up over time. And ako, personally, ang sinasuggest ko lang na allocation for insurance is around 10, maximum 20% of your income. Para meron ka pang buffer for other stuff na mas pressing, mas immediate yung need. Kasi insurance is a need, yes. Pero meron din mga urgent needs, di ba?
Like food,
oo. Lalo na kung pamilyado ka na, di ba? Ano ba unahin mo? Gatas ng anak mo o yung insurance mo, di ba?
That's true.
So yun yung three considerations, at least for now, na pwede mong tingnan.
Ibang perspective naman yun, no? Like, at least we're coming from a financial planner talaga na who guides people. When it comes to insurance, like, you know, marami kasing talagang insurance products out there, and marami ring insurance agents out there. Marami ring insurance companies out there. You have Sun Life, you have Manulife, you have Crew Life, anything na may life.
Mm-mm.
Parang ganun yung punchline nila, basta my life. But the most important thing is you also have to understand nga kung bakit mo gusto magkaroon ng insurance.
Yes, okay. Correct.
Okay, so before we end, no, I'm sure you have received a lot of value from Garett here. And meron kasi tayong tinatawag na question of the day.
Okay, ano yan?
So, ngayon, ang mangyari is, ikaw yung magbigay ng question of the day sa kanila.
Okay.
So, any question that you want to ask the audience so that we can interact in the comments
section. Okay, siguro ang question for the day ko is, what hinders you from actually investing?
Boom. Okay. What hinders you from actually investing? Sa Tagalog, paano mo yung Tagalog yun?
Bakit hindi ka nag-i-invest? Anong pumipigil sa'yo? Bakit hindi ka nag-i-invest? Kasi may pera naman tayo eh. Di ba?
Okay. Maganda yun. Again, investing is good, but you have to understand it. So at least malaman namin kung through the comment section kung what hinders you from investing. And before we end, paano ka nila ma-reach in case they wanna have an interaction with you?
Okay, you could reach me via the Bright Millennial Facebook page. Meron din kami Instagram pero not as active. So you could just message the Bright Millennial page or pwede mo rin akong i-add directly sa Facebook account ko, Garett Maralit.
So guys, thank you very much. Thank you, Garett,
thank you, Jan, for having
this opportunity
me here.
Na to be, umaga, collaborate with you, like the Bright Millennial, tapos the Present. It's a good collaboration. Nakita lang kami dito sa New Bold University. Yeah. And which I'm hoping that we're gonna interview the owner and the founder, so that malaman din ninyo kung anong value nito. So
yes.
We met here. I actually attended his talk, and then he was talking about social media, the Bright Millennial, and then boom, this happened. So that's the good thing of learning at the same time in a conference like this, because you get to interact with different people. Okay, so thank you very much for being with us, and see you in the next video.
Thank you, guys.